Here's another question asking about the effective interest rate, in this case called the annual percentage yield. So in the previous example, we calculated the effective interest rate by hand, and now we'll use the formula. The formula is that the annual percentage yield, or the effective interest rate, is equal to, in parentheses, 1 plus r over n raised to the power of n minus 1. Now remember, there's nothing magical about this formula. This formula simply does the process we did in the last example all in one step, where we calculated how much the compound account would grow and then found the simple interest rate that would give the same kind of growth in 1 year. But this formula does that work for us. So if you ever forget this formula and you need it, you can always do it the long way, the way that we did in the last example, but this formula does the same process more quickly. So, to calculate the annual percentage yield, or the effective interest rate on this account, we just plug in everything that's given. So, the interest rate is 0.045, written as a decimal. N is 12, since it's compounded monthly, so we replace that both in the denominator and in the exponent with 12. Subtract 1, and now all we have to do is calculate this. So, in parentheses, we have the 1 plus 0.045 divided by 12. We get that answer. Raise that to the 12th power, and then finally subtract 1 to get our final answer, that the annual percentage yield is 0.04594, which corresponds to a percentage of 4.594%. So as we've seen before, the effective interest rate, or the APY, tends to be higher than the compound interest rate, because compound interest grows the account faster. So a simple interest account needs a higher interest rate to see the same kind of growth. So in general, the APY is higher than the APR,